They talking about making industry music. They want me to cap to y'all, but ain't gon' cap to y'all, cause I went there when they ain't had a ball. He talking sporty, wonder how he felt watching his dog cast the ball. I had to tell my wife to stop, he don't like to pass the ball. That ticket, he talking thick hit, I was kicking in houses for it. That's two different tickets, right? Oh yeah, they loud, boy. Them players lazy, they don't get no bread.
Welcome to week one of the NFL preseason, where the rookies of today hope to become the stars of tomorrow. It's the Dolphins and the Bears, and it comes your way next.
A fairly short kick from the 14. And he takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, call it the 26. Now Tua Tagovailoa gets set to lead this Dolphins offense for the first time.
To absolutely no one's surprise, the Dolphins did invest a high first round pick, number 5 overall, to draft Tua in 2020. I think that most people would say that his rookie year had plenty of positives, but it was sprinkled with a few negatives as well. Remember, he controversially took over for Ryan Fitzpatrick during the open week prior to week 8. Miami did go 6-3 in his starts from that time, but he had to get rescued a few times in games by Fitzmagic. And in his own words, he called his rookie year below average. I don't think the franchise believes that, but they're looking forward to seeing him improve.
Yeah, they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
They'll run on first down, Edmonds. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. So back-to-back big runs, picking apart this defense on the opening drive.
I thought this was a passing league. I thought this was the era we were in where the ball was always in the air, right?
They didn't get the memo.
And they didn't get the memo, and I know this to be true. Offensive linemen still, to this day, they want to run the football. They want to fire out and hit people across the line of scrimmage, and they're clearing space.
5 yards remain on second down. Running left, here's Edmonds. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. 41 yards rushing for him now, and he's only carried the ball 4 times.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
Play action, now it's Tua. He'll swing that out to Edmonds. That catch good for only a couple. They should have got more out of that, though. He was wide open.
I love how emphatic you are with that call, because that's exactly what I was thinking. Wide open in the flat. Give him a ball that he can use to get upfield with, not just catch and go over the sideline. They cost themselves some yardage there.
Off of play action, Tagovailoa. There's the first NFL catch for the first rounder, Jaylen Waddle. And so close, he gets it to the 1. Out of bounds right there. First and goal, a chance for an early statement here on the road. Michelle will score. Touchdown, Miami.
That's just a solid, methodical drive to start this game.
And how about how it culminated? Doing exactly what they wanted to do, getting the ball downfield, and then running it into the end zone. I'm just telling you, partner, when you run it in rather than throw it in, that hurts a defense psychologically a heck of a lot more.
Extra point up and good by Sanders, and it's now a 7-0 game. Taken at the goal line. And he won't quite make it to the 25. The Bears offense making their way out now for their first drive with Justin Fields, the rookie from Ohio State, at quarterback. Fields. That one tipped and it's incomplete. But good hands there defensively at second down. Charles, a look there at the Bears draft class for 2021. A lot of guys there that will wind up contributors. I think you agree with that. But this draft, ultimately, it's going to come down to one question. Was Justin Fields the right choice or not?
And a bold move the Bears made, moving up from number 20 to number 11 to get him. Not a huge jump, but still a striking play by them. And definitely a splashy pick for this team. And they have to hit a home run at the quarterback position. Only one other draft pick on day two, and that was Tevin Jenkins, the big offensive tackle from Oklahoma State, who some had pegged in the first round. I thought he was going to go to the Indianapolis Colts in that spot.
First down, they run again. Here's Montgomery. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. Couple of nice carries back to back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these aren't bare bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yard you're looking for, right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? Five or more yards each time. That's what you're looking for in setting the tone and getting your offensive line going.
Good sign on the opening drive. On second down, Montgomery. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation we were talking about with one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly, it's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. 46 yards rushing for him now in the ball game. Options galore here, second and a few inches. Hand off comes to Montgomery. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Got an open man, it's Pringle. Touchdown, Bears! Byron Pringle from 19 yards away. And the Bears are an extra point away from tying the football game. Walking into the stadium, we saw a ton of people donning the jerseys of this rookie quarterback, so you know they love that opening drive, and he throws a touchdown pass.
He gave a little bit of confirmation about what they had hoped, right? Because they thought they had a quarterback. They're thinking they have a quarterback. You do this, they believe they've got a quarterback. Look up, elbowing each other up in the stands. That's our guy.
Santos able to tack on the extra point. Score here this opening quarter of play. Each team's had it, each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Pulls it in at the 13. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21. So Miami coming out for their second drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
In on the stop, the former Georgia Bulldog, Roquan Smith.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Second down and another run with Edmonds. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Now they're staring at a third and eight. That last play backwards a yard. Looking to pass, Tua. And going deep for Hill. Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted, thrown back across his body. Picked off at the 47. And his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively, getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
And he's across midfield and into Miami territory. 5 yards, now it's third and five. Back to throw, Fields. Hard throw, incomplete. Well, the other day they told us when we've got third and five or less, we have to be able to convert. And I guess every team would say that, Charles, but an opportunity miss there.
What they were trying to tell us is they believe it's a matchup game at that point. And they liked some matchups that they had, thought they could exploit them, unable to do so on that play.
On is the punt team now as this one sent away. And this one hits at the three and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. Miami's offense set and ready to go. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. And he finds some space past the 25 to the 27. They'll try and run for it. Here's Michelle. And it would appear he's going to be short of a first down as he stopped right around the 29. Just a 2-yard pickup, and that should necessitate a call for the punt team here on fourth down. Here's Thomas Morstead on now to punt it away on fourth down.
Back deep for Chicago, Dads Newsom.
It's a return of four following a 42-yard punt, and the Bears take over. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive, and they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked
somewhere. Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
They run, Montgomery. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver. But he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes it's his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up three on that carry.
On the completion, and it sets up a third down. Off play action, Fields rolling to his right. Now he'll let it go deep right side. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked up by Xavier Howard. And the Dolphins are going to get possession of the football as time will run out on this first quarter of play. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs, and that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
They had 3 yards on first down, just 1 yard there.
That's a really good job right there. Just kept stringing that play out, pushing further and further towards the sideline. Really good fundamentals by that defense.
He was trying to put his foot in the ground and turn upfield. He just couldn't.
No, they really had a picket fence in front of him. No room to find to get upfield.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sand.
Didn't give him points for the attempt, but there was just a wave of pressure there. A host of people in the area. Evades a few, but couldn't evade all of them.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. It'll be a 41-yard punt, give him five on the return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
They'll contain him to just four. Second down. Get a yard, maybe two, up to the 46.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Now Simeon. And he fires one, but incomplete.
I'll tell you what, these last couple of drives, much better from a defensive perspective. They gave up a touchdown on the opening drive. And then after forcing a punt on their last possession, it looks like they're going to get the football back again.
Now on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. And this ball is going to be down now right at the 10-yard line. Good spot. So they'll play the field position game here as a very nice punt is going to pin them back.
Yeah, it's almost like watching a game of tennis, or do you prefer ping pong, you know, back and forth like that? That definitely was excellent, wasn't it?
Now it's the backup, Bridgewater. Completes it to the tight end, Smythe. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to him.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down.
Well, that was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down. The last run got a couple here. Second and 8. Now Bridgewater. His throw incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well and that one's incomplete.
Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
Yeah, it's a nice job there defensively to blank those receivers on third down. And as a quarterback, all you can do is just lock one toward the bench, not too close, mind you, and live to punt the football.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. And good hustle here as this is going to be blown dead right at the 9-yard line.
Well, someone's going to be happy with that effort. You know who else is going to be happy? His defense.
Absolutely.
He's created a very long field for that offense to try to traverse.
And he got some help from Mr. Football there, checking up nicely. Good English on that punt. On first down, Herbert, and just not much to be had there. 1 yard out to the 10. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
On second and 9, Simeon. Here's Griffin on the catch. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line.
Let's go, Bears.
A big connection on that one. 36 yards. So that changes things. Here's first and 10 all the way up at the 45.
First and 10 at the 45-yard line.
Here's a handoff out of the gun. And he's across midfield and into Miami territory. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what'll be a 3rd and 4.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature in the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Over the dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
Here we go on 4th, Simeon. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. A lack of discipline defensively on 4th down, and now that leads to a 1st and 10. Hands it off out of the gun. And only a yard this time as he's taken down right around the 26. The run only got a yard. Here's 2nd and 9. Back to throw, Simeon. And he rifles one incomplete.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
Throwing on 3rd down, Simeon. And that is incomplete.
I'm not sure it made a difference on that play, but one thing to keep in mind, here in the early part of the year during a day game, the sun does play a factor on deep balls.
And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. So the scoring drive encompasses 9 plays, and the net result, 3 points.
Take your disappointment and put it aside. 9 points.